How do you stop art theft? What is digital art theft? Tony here, we talk art and design tech. Subscribe for more. If you have artwork online and your work is any good, people will try to steal it. We've all heard of that popular artist online whose artwork was out on some sketchy t-shirt site without their permission, or a lesser known artist that has had their work stolen and printed on a mug or coaster. The moment you put your work online, it's gone. But there's a few ways you can protect yourself. This is not legal advice. Post your artwork in a video with a watermark. With the rise of TikTok Shorts and the Reels feature on Instagram, more and more artists and creatives are using video over images. This can be done with your phone or a high-quality camera. And this method allows you to share your work without the worry of it being stolen or printed on a t-shirt store in another country somewhere. You can share how you create your work or even do reveals of the final work. The sky is the limit really with video, and I would suggest it for sure. Process photos of your work. If you're not feeling the video thing and you decide to post your work instead, always put a process image of the work that you created within the post that you're posting. In the event that you have to go after a company or an individual selling your work online or sharing it without giving the artist credit, you can provide that you are the originator of the work by showing the process of its creation. Posting it online on platforms like Instagram will also connect it to a date it was posted, giving you a better chance of providing that you posted it first. Make sure that you upload your images at a lower quality online so that they're not printed or put up in a store to be resold and printed on a t-shirt. Make sure that you don't upload your work on the highest quality. I've heard people mention 72 DPI, but okay, DPI has nothing to do with the image quality. DPI is something that a laser or inkjet printer uses to print the resolution of your image on paper. Okay, we got it out. It's out there. It's in the world. Now you know. You can click this link to find the full video explaining everything that you need to know about DPI and what it actually means. The higher resolution quality, it makes it easier for people to re-upload your work online in different places and resell it as merch or prints as well. Question of the day, which method so far seems like a good solution for your work? Put it below in the comments. I've seen recommendations to upload work at 600 by 600 resolution, but sites like ArtStation, DeviantArt, and others may have uploading restrictions. This way, the moment that someone tries to take your work and enlarge it and print it, the quality is going to be horrible. So you win. Some companies may still try to print your stuff on phone cases or smaller merchandise, stickers, things like that. So just keep that in mind. This could be frustrating and an extra step, but it's preferred over having to track them down for selling your work and probably creating a bad name for you because the quality is going to be trash. They just want to make a quick buck. So just bear that in mind. A lot of people want to pursue these people, but I want to help you not have to. So some of these things are put out there with the intention of helping you not get your work stolen. Watermarks, very predictable. You've probably heard this 1,000 times. So most artists, they really hate the way that watermarks look on their work, but they can literally help you not get your work stolen or shared without the proper credit. In the perfect world, that would be the end of the conversation, but most people don't credit the artist, and that's where watermarks come in handy. So at least people can find you online. The downside to adding watermarks is that they can take away from the work. If it's a large watermark and it covers most of the image, or smaller but near the edges around your work, it can be easily cropped out. A solution to this is to hide your watermark within your work or out of view. You can also have a large watermark in view just to throw them off and maintain your credit if it's later printed or sold without your permission, having that smaller out-of-view watermark within it as well. For that motivated art theft, they may even paint over your watermark, but it can be worth it to have a super secret hidden watermark, like I mentioned before, outside of sight. Copyright. Copyright is a nice piece of paper, and it proves that you are the owner of the title of your artwork, literally the name of your artwork. These only record the name of the work. So there is no picture or image connected with your copyright registered with the US Copyright Office. It usually costs about $35, and that's per image that you have copyrighted. If you produce a large volume of work, I'm not sure that this is worth it, especially with the fact that you still have to prove that you are the originator of the art with your online platforms. If you want to pursue getting a copyright, it may make more sense to design a logo or symbol that you put on your work instead of paying $35 every time you upload online.